Question number one. For shows and markets, do you think stocking up and having a ton of items is beneficial or keep it somewhat minimal? This question was asked because they said that they thought my setup that I did over the weekend looked like I didn't have, like I wasn't packed full of stock. So that's what made them think of this question, like probably thinking, did she do that on purpose? I didn't do it on purpose. I just didn't have a lot. They told me the day before, hey, can you come do this market tomorrow? And I was like, sure, the next day. So that's where I just kind of took what I had with me already made. But I did something about this last weekend. This was the first time that I have done a setup that I enjoyed the way it looked. I felt like it had an aesthetic that I was going for. It was very on brand for a crafty concept. And this was the first show that I've ever done that I was actually happy with the setup. I do not have style. That does not come natural to me. I was FaceTiming Taylor before my market, asking her if I should do this or this. Does she have any ideas for this? Like, it's just not natural for me. And I was really happy with how this weekend turned out. I got a lot of compliments, definitely from you guys, but also from fellow entrepreneur friends that were at the market as well. They were like, "Oh man, your setup looks so pretty." And it probably was had something to do with not being over packed full of supplies and like things to buy. What I would recommend is you need to find the sweet spot for your booth size. Mine was a 10 by 10, and you need to find how many products you can have in an organized way where it looks like you have stuff that they need to look at. Like they can't just see everything by walking right by. Like they need to get in there and look at it a little bit, see the different color options, take a close-up look at some of the tiny things like earrings. But not so overwhelmed where they're gonna have to dig and dig and dig, like at a clearance bin in TJ Maxx or something, or a clearance rack where everything's all different sizes, everything's all different colors, tanks and tees all mixed together, and jeans and pajamas and bras. Like, you wanna be organized and enticing, but not stressful on your customers when they're coming to look. Also, if you want to take, you're gonna want to take extra stock, even if it's not out in display for everyone to see. Hide it under the tables, hide it behind your displays, places where it can't be seen at all. And when you sell a piece, go back into your extra stock, pull out another piece, and put it where that one just came out of. That way, your booth always stays stocked up. That's what I did over the weekend with my earrings. I had a little tote, it's over there, full of extra earrings, and whenever I sold one off of my earring wall, I just went to my tote, got another one, and hung it up in that same spot. So my earring wall was always full. I did decide that if I ran out of extra earrings, I would start keeping my empty slots down at the bottom. I would keep still like reorganize my display so the empty slots were at the bottom instead of just all battleship style throughout the whole display. I think that would look better. I didn't get to that point. Actually, I didn't sell more than I had, so I didn't have to do that, but something to think about. Also, for earring display, something I would have done differently if I had had more time was I would have organized them in like a color spectrum, like the rainbow spectrum. I think that's just really appealing and would also draw people in, like, "Ooh, look at that pretty rainbow wall. What is that? Oh, those are earrings. That's so cool." So that's something that I would have done differently and will do differently in the future. I hope I answered that question to your liking. Most of the things that sold at my market were the inexpensive-er things. The less expensive things. Scrunchies sold really well, earrings sold pretty good, and I sold three Claire Bun beanies, which in 80-degree weather in August is not that bad. What else did I sell? I think, and then clearance bin stuff, I think that was it. I didn't sell a single pillow or a single wall hanger, and those were $35 and up price range, so it might not have just been the right audience for that price level. I'm not sure. I'll have to just do things a little differently and keep trial and error until I figure it out, and then I'll let you guys know what works to save you guys all the hassle of trial and error.
If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more videos on crochet business questions, be sure to join the Ashante Crochet Facebook group. We do lives every Tuesday and answer business questions you guys have asked us there in the group. Also, if you have any more questions about markets, I have a blog post for you guys. If this is your first time doing a market and you need some tips, I will link that below. And there's also a fantastic post by Hannah over at the Crafty Fox Crochet, where she gives you 10 crochet patterns that she believes are perfect for selling at handmade markets. I hope to see you guys over in the Ashante Crochet Facebook group. Have a fantastic day.